For as far as we know, alchemists failed to create gold, but I found myself wondering, I have a 3D printer. Could I print gold? Of course, not the kind that carries real weight or melts in a furnace, but something that looks and feels like it could. This project started as a simple experiment, a 3D printed brick turned into something more convincing, real, heavy, valuable, beautifully imperfect. But there's one thing 3D prints don't have, weight. And that's where you come in. What could I add to give it a believable heft? I was thinking sand, but maybe you have a better idea. And when all the bars are finished, I want you to tell me which one looks the most real to gold. I started by looking up dimensions of real gold bars, the kind you see stacked in vaults or behind glass in a museum. It reminded me of a visit I made to the Bank of England Museum, where they actually let you hold a real gold bar. The thing that surprised me wasn't how dense it was, but the way it felt valuable before even lifting it. That's the feeling I want to recreate here. Not the weight itself, but the illusion of it. So I modeled the bar to match real proportions, clean edges, slight curvature, and a scale that would catch the light like the real thing. Once the design was ready, I moved into Bambu Studio to prepare it for printing, adjusting layer heights, infill, while imagining how light would hit each surface. I wanted to see how different PLA filaments would affect the illusion of gold. In total, I printed 7 bars, 5 in PLA black as base painting later, 1 in Overture gold and 1 with Bambu Labs gold. 7 prints, 3 materials, each offering different take on what gold could be. With the prints finished, it was time to turn those rough surfaces into something smooth and solid. I printed them in fine setting, hoping the layer lines wouldn't stand too proud, and it definitely helped. But even with a smooth surface, you can still feel those subtle ridges when the light hits the print. So before paint could go on, I needed a clean, even surface. I used my DeWalt sander with some P180 sandpaper, coarse enough to take down the lines without chewing through the PLA. The goal here wasn't perfection, it was about leveling the texture so the primer could go on evenly later. Once the sanding was underway, it became all about the rhythm. Smooth, steady passes, letting the tool do the work. The goal wasn't to erase every single line, but to soften them until the surface felt consistent to the touch. After a few minutes, the bars started to change completely. The shine of the plastic dulled, replaced by a uniform matte finish, the real first signs that these were transforming into something new. Once the sanding was done, I needed to clear away the dust and residue before priming. I used IPA to wipe down each piece. It's perfect for removing oils and fine dust without leaving any residue. I avoided using water on PLA because it can absorb, and that can lead to warping or adhesion issues later when painting. It's a simple step, but it makes a big difference, giving the surface that clean, dry texture that prime loves to stick to. With everything clean and ready, it was time for prime, the real transformation stage. I used High Coats Filler Primer Spray, which works beautifully on 3D prints. It fills layer lines and helps to create a smooth and even finish. When spraying, I kept the can about 15 to 20 centimeters away, applying a light, overlapping pass. A few thin coats are always better than one heavy. As it dried, you can see the surface began to level out. The shine of the plastic faded, replaced by a soft, uniform finish. I set the two bars aside to cure for 24 hours, letting the prime harden fully. After the first coat had cured, I came back and gave the bar a light sand with 240 grit paper, then applied a second coat of primer to really perfect the surface. Once the coat had fully dried, it was time for the final stage of prep. Here I'm sanding with 400 grit paper, just enough to take down the fine texture and leave a silky smooth finish ready for paint. It's a simple step, but it makes all the difference. The smoother the base, the more gold finish, will catch and reflect light. And that's where the illusion really starts to come to life. Next, I opened up the shimmering metallic paint. And right away, it looked beautiful in the lid, full of sparkle and depth. I poured a little into a small roller tray and decided to apply it using a mini roller instead of a brush. That way I could get a smoother, even finish without visible strokes. I admit, I don't have high hopes for this one. The label says designed for metal and wood, not plastic. But that's the fun part with projects like this. Testing materials, seeing what sticks, and finding out whether something not made for the job can still surprise you. So, this wasn't exactly planned. I realized I accidentally painted both of the bars I primed using the same metallic gold paint, and while it was still wet, a few small bubbles started appearing on the surface, so I decided to do a little experiment. I grabbed my DeWalt heat gun to see if a bit of gentle heat would smooth out the paint and release the bubbles. And surprisingly, it actually worked. The bubbles disappeared, the surface evened out quite nicely. I left them to dry completely, and while they were curing, I printed a new PLA bar ready for the next round of painting, this time using liquid metal acrylic in yellow gold from C. Roberson and Co. This paint actually has quite a story behind it. It was given to me by a retired painter and decorator I was chatting to. He said he used to keep it for touching up old gold finishes. It's an old pot, and even after all these years, it still looks beautiful. The consistency is quite thick, almost creamy, with a subtle gold sparkle that catches the light even before it's applied. I decided not to prime this bar, mostly to save time, but also because the paint itself felt quite heavy, and I thought it was enough to cover the surfaces on its own. I began with a brush, but the paint was so thick it left clear lines across the surface. I then switched to a roller to smooth it out, which helped a little but left bumps instead. So I switched back and forth a few times, so brush, roller, trying to get the perfect balance between smooth coverage and texture. In the end, I decided to let it dry completely before moving on to the next step, where I'll see if a light sanding can bring out a smoother metallic finish. I let the bar dry for 24 hours to make sure the paint had fully cured before sanding. Once it was ready, I came back at it with some 400 grit sandpaper and made a short time lapse of the process to see how much of a difference it would make. The surface felt firm, not tacky at all, and the sanding did help to reduce the bumps, giving a finish a smoother touch. But in a few areas, it took off more paint than expected, leaving patches where the gold thinned out. So I decided it would need a second coat, which I'll be applying in the next time lapse. Hopefully that layer will even out and bring some shine back. I started this stage by applying a second coat of paint. This time I went straight in with a brush, and it actually went on much better than before. The paint felt smoother, the brush left smaller, finer lines, which gave the surface a much more consistent texture overall. I kept the application light, just enough to even out the patches where the sanding had thinned out the first coat. As it went on, the gold really started to come to life. The color deepened, the coverage looked richer, and the finish had a warm metallic glow that left a far closer look to real gold. I left it to dry again, and the surface already looked much more balanced than the first attempt. Before moving on to rub and buff finishes, I gave the last three bricks a quick sand using 240 grit paper. This helps remove any slight textures and gives the wax a better surface to grip onto. I'm not using any primer for these. I want to see how the finish reacts directly onto the bare PLA. Once all three were smoothed down, they were ready for the first test. For the first brick, I used rub and buff in antique gold. I applied a small amount onto a soft cloth and started working it across the surface. Instead of fighting against the print lines, I decided to work with them. They actually helped catch the light really nicely, adding a sort of print grain texture to the finish, and the wax even filled in some of the tiny gaps that sanding hadn't fully removed. The texture was instant. The dull plastic started to take on a metallic glow. Antique gold has this deep, almost bronze-like tone, not overly bright, more like an aged metal that's darkened slightly over time. It's a really interesting finish, subtle, warm, and more understated than I expected. I'll leave this one to dry before moving on to the next shade. For the second brick, I used Rub and Buff Gold Leaf, and straight away I could tell this one was much more brighter and more reflective than antique gold. I applied a small amount onto a soft cloth and worked in the same way as before, glowing along the print lines to help finish catch the light evenly. It spread smoothly and finished the surface really well, almost like liquid metal. Under the light, it looked far richer and cleaner, a strong, bold gold tone that instantly stood out. It does lean a bit yellow, especially compared to the warmer bronze antique gold, but it has that eye-catching shine you'd expect from something called gold leaf. I'll let this one set and move on to the final color. For the final brick, I used Rub and Buff in Grecian Gold. I applied it the same way as the others, a small amount on a soft cloth, working along the print lines to keep the subtle texture consistent. Straight away, I noticed that this shade felt more balanced. Not as dark as the antique gold, but not as bright or yellow as the gold leaf. The tone sits right in between, with a soft warmth that looks natural and refined. It spreads beautifully, filling any tiny gaps left in the surface and leaving a smooth, even sheen that almost looks like brushed metal. Out of the three, I think this one's my favorite so far, and probably the closest to how I imagined real gold would look in this finish. After letting all three bars set for 24 hours, it was time to bring out the final shine. I grabbed a clean, soft cloth and started gently polishing each one. Nothing heavy, just enough pressure to buff the surface and bring out that true metallic glow. The difference was immediate. After polishing each bar, it had its own personality. Seeing them together really showed how much character a simple wax finish can bring to a 3D print. With all three bars polished and shining nicely, I wanted to protect the finishes and give them a bit more durability. So I added a small strip of masking tape to the side of each bar just to keep track of which color was which while spraying. Then I grabbed a can of Rust-Oleum Crystal Clear Coat and gave each bar a few light, even passes. I kept the can around 15 to 20 centimeters away and built up thin layers rather than one heavy coat. That way it keeps the metallic finish sharp without clouding it. The clear coat settled beautifully and added just a subtle gloss, sealing the finish while still letting the different tones of antique gold, gold leaf, and Grecian gold hold their own character. With all the bars now finished and polished, here's the lineup. I started by stacking them together. It's not hard to appreciate just how different each one feels, though they all started from the same print. Now let's take a closer look at each one. Number one is the Overture Royal Gold PLA. This one had no extra work done, just printed on fine settings straight off the printer. It had a clean, shiny, yellowy gold tone that looked surprisingly good even without any post-processing. Number 2, Bambu Lab Gold PLA. Again, no extra work done, printed on fine settings straight off the printer. It has more of a muted, refined gold tone, not as bright or reflective as the Overture filament, but still distinctively gold with a soft, more natural warmth to it. Number 3, the Shining Gold Metallic Paint. This one looked lovely in the can. Smooth, glossy, and full of promise, but on the brick, it just didn't translate. It's shiny, yes, but left every print line visible on the black PLA. To be fair, the label does say it's made for metal and wood, not plastic, so it never really stood a chance. Number 4 is C. Robinson & Co.'s Liquid Metal Acrylic Yellow Gold. This one brought the finish back to life. Thick, rich, and full of character. Once dry, it had a soft metallic sheen that looked beautifully balanced, sitting somewhere between painted gold and a true metal surface. It's the kind of finish that feels handcrafted, almost like leaf work. Number 5, a rub and buff Grecian gold. Warm, soft and elegant. It bridges everything you've seen so far. Compared to the raw filaments and the painted pieces, this one feels the most complete. Subtle sheen, even texture and genuine metallic look. There are a few small blemishes here and there, but that's mostly from fingerprints and me not being quite careful enough when handling. It's nothing to do with the finish itself. Number 6 is the rub and buff antique gold. Deep and bronzy with that aged patina that makes it feel like it's been around for years. It catches the light softly, less bright than others, but rich and timeless. And number 7 is the rub and buff goldleaf. Bright, bold and reflective, the most vivid of the set. It has a classic polished gold look that instantaneously catches your eye under the light. Each finish tells a slightly different story on how you can turn a simple 3D print into something that looks convincingly like gold. But now it's over to you. Which one do you think looked like the most real gold? Drop your vote in the comments below.